When young people break a bone, their bones heal reliably and fast, whereas in the elderly, bones don't heal that quickly anymore or don't heal at all. Oftentimes, we just replace parts rather than hoping that their bone will heal or regenerate. My name is Philipp Leucht. I'm an orthopedic surgeon and associate professor at NYU Langone Health. The purpose of our research is to rejuvenate stem cells, the building blocks of regeneration. So kids have a lot of stem cells in their bones, and that allows these bones to heal quickly. When we age, our body begins to degenerate, causing a low-grade inflammation that affects all tissues, and it also affects the bones by leading to a loss of stem cells in the bone and a loss of function of these stem cells, which then leads to osteoporosis. The discovery was that the treatment may be as simple as just taking an anti-inflammatory, which is a really promising idea. Having identified that this aging state is reversible really has huge implication for everyone, because we're all going to age. A broken bone can lead to many other conditions: loss of independence, pressure sores, pneumonia, and eventually even death. So being able to avoid all these downstream effects from a broken bone would change the practice of medicine. I grew up in Bochum, Germany. I encountered my first broken bone. I was fascinated by the skeleton and how it heals. I went to medical school, focusing only on orthopedic traumatology. So about 2 years into my first residency in Germany, I realized that just putting plates and screws on bones was not really fulfilling. I really needed to understand why do certain bones heal and why certain bones don't heal. We're at the cusp of a new era. The future of orthopedic surgery is not designing new screws and plates. The next thing is biologics, improving stem cells that help patients heal. So we treated mice with anti-inflammatories for a certain time period, and to our surprise, we found that these aged mice treated with an anti-inflammatory healed as well as young mice did. The next step of this research is to move this exciting discovery from the mouse into clinical practice. For me, what makes research so exciting and interesting is to be able to identify something that no one has seen before and that can really lead to game-changing therapies for our patients. NYU Langone really has been the perfect environment for me to do this kind of research. What I have here is very unique: to be able to work with clinicians, to have access to samples from the operating room, from patients. As both an orthopedic surgeon and a scientist, I can function as the bridge between bench and bedside, which is really exciting.